Hello everyone, hope you all are doing fine. Let us today discuss about the peritoneum. Peritoneum is a large serous membrane lining the abdominal cavity. It is composed of fibrous tissue and mesothelial cells. Fibrous tissue forms the outer layer and it provides the strength, while the mesothelial cell form the inner layer and it secrete fluid. Peritoneum is in the form of cloth sac, which is invaginated by numbers of viscera, and its division, talking about its division, it has two divisions, which are parietal peritoneum and visceral peritoneum. So let's see, in the figure here we have our greater sac and the lesser sac. Let's talk about the peritoneum along here. So there is a bare area in the liver where there is no any covering of the peritoneum. So let us start from the side of this area. So this peritoneum moves downward from here till the urinary bladder to the uterus and forming a pouch here to the rectum. This one is in female only, but see, in males there is urinary bladder, then the peritoneum, after covering the urinary bladder, it goes directly to the rectum. So after rectum, it moves upward right like this, also giving a fold to the small intestine here, and then it moves to the pancreas, giving its folding to transverse colon, then to the stomach, then again goes and attaches to the part here in the liver. So this one forms the greater sac. Again, let's go to the lesser sac. We have here the bare area of the liver. In the side of it, let's start from here, it moves downward like this, giving its covering to the stomach, then to the transverse colon, then to the pancreas like this, then it's move upward and then joins here. This one is our lesser sac. So we have lesser omentum and greater omentum here. This one is our lesser omentum and this one right here is our greater omentum. There are four layers in the greater omentum. It contains our right and left gastroepiploic vessels and its anastomosis and fat. It hangs down from the greater curvature of the stomach. And talking about its function, it protects from infection due to presence of macrophages patches. Also, there is a very interesting thing here. Greater omentum is also known as the policeman of the abdomen because it checks out the infection from spreading. Now there is a small foramen up here which is known as epiploic foramen, and it helps in the communication of the greater sac and the lesser sac. Now talking about the lesser omentum, it has two modifications, which are hepatogastric ligament and hepatoduodenal ligament. Talking about its content, it has hepatic artery proper, the portal vein, bile duct, lymph node and lymphatics, and hepatic plexus of nerves. So up here then we have this folding giving to intestine, we call this mesentery. Then this one here, the folding of this transverse colon, we called transverse mesocolon. Let's talk about the recesses of the lesser sac. So we have here inferior recess and here we have superior recess. So let's talk about the pouches now. Here we can see the pouches between urinary bladder and uterus and uterus and rectum. So as this pouch is between the urinary bladder and the uterus, we call this vesico-uterine pouch, and as this pouch is between the uterus and rectum, we call it recto-uterine pouch. So this is the peritoneum. Now let us discuss something about the epiploic foramen. So I have drawn a rough figure here also. Epiploic foramen is a vertical sip like opening that helps in the communication of greater and lesser sac. So here we can see the epiploic foramen. This one I have written EF is for the epiploic foramen. So let us talk about the boundaries of the epiploic foramen. We have, this one is our anterior side. As we can see the vertebra here, so this must be the anterior side. In the anterior side, we have our portal vein, proper hepatic artery, pile duct, and the right free margin of the lesser omentum. So in the posterior side, as we can see, we have inferior vena cava, suprarenal gland, and the T-tubal vertebra. So in the upper part, superior region, as we can see, we have caudate process of the liver, and in the inferior part, it must be a little bit here, we have first part of duodenum and the horizontal part of the proper hepatic artery. Thank you.